But it's great. It's always nice to come home and perform in front of my perform in front of a home county crowd, because I travel to some really shitty places. I performed at a comedy club one time that was located right next to a bowling alley. You ever been inside a bowling alley? It's one of the most depressing places in the world. You ever see the people who are in a bowling alley? The only time they're ever going to see the number 300 is when they step on the bathroom scale. You travel to some of these small towns, the waiting rooms in some of these in some of the comedy clubs where I perform, they look more like the dressing room for an audience for the Maury Povich show. It's always the scum of the earth that appear on those shows, isn't it? The subject of the Maury Povich show is never anything like, you didn't buy enough caviar for our state dinner with the ambassador from Papua New Guinea. No. The subject of the Maury Povich show is always something like, I masturbate thinking about my pregnant 19-year-old daughter to relive the memory of how she got that way. One piece of advice I give for, one piece of advice I give for comedians, if you get the chance to perform at senior citizen centers and old folks' homes, do it. Please do it. I mean, it's a great experience. You can fart on stage and no one will suspect it's you. And if you forget your jokes, you can go ahead and do the same ones again and they won't know the difference. I get those reactions a lot whenever I perform these jokes. I've had this friend of mine, I've known him close to 30 years. He came up to me the other day and said, Tom, I shudder whenever I hear the words that come out of your mouth. Then I have to remind him he's the one who stopped taking his anti-seizure medication. Jokes like that are the reason why the chances of me getting booked in a major comedy club are slightly less than the chances of North Korea commissioning their own version of Undercover Boss. Every episode ends the same way. Kim Jong-un gathers all the workers and just summarily executes them all. That's a dream gig. But my agent gave me this the other day. He said, you know, Tom, the reason you have trouble getting booked in a lot of major comedy clubs is you don't know how to write jokes for the average American. You need to learn how to write jokes that relate to the average American. And I'll be honest, I can't write jokes that relate to the average American because I don't know how to write jokes in Spanish. And clearly from that reaction, I don't even know how to write jokes that relate to the average American in English. You know who I really feel bad for? I really feel bad for Stevie Wonder because he can never pull off a cover of Amazing Grace. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now, shit!